Is that thing rolling?
Yeah.
Oh, all right. I'm going to make a redneck meatloaf, or my version of it, a really simple meatloaf. And I hear a lot of people say they like meatloaf with gravy. I do too, but unfortunately I don't really know how to make the gravy. So this is how I make meatloaf when I want to make meatloaf. And it's pretty tasty, and you can pretty much adjust it any way you want it. I start with about 3/4 of a cup to a cup of breadcrumbs. You can use whatever you want, Italian, plain. And what I do is I get them wet, and I kind of mix them up, and then I just kind of let it, I kind of let that moisture kind of like set into the breadcrumb, because for some reason that'll give you a moisture. Like if you're making meatballs, it seems to make the meat moister. I don't know why, but it does. I kind of learned that from a cooking show a while back and tried it out, and it fucking works. And then I get, you can put your diced onion in there if you'd like, or peppers, or whatever you want. I put a little bit of black pepper right into the breadcrumb mix, because that's like your dry stuff for me. The fuck, is there any pepper left in here? All right, so put a little bit of pepper in there, kind of kick it up a little bit. You can put more.
It looks like a lot of pepper.
Okay, so it's a lot of pepper.
I can only have so much pepper.
A little bit of salt. You can salt your breadcrumbs too, because that'll mix in with the meat and everything else. And then I don't even mess around. I take 2 eggs, brown or white. 1 egg. Two eggs. Try not to get the shell in there, otherwise you'll have crunchy meatloaf, which, you know, some people might like. And then about a pound. I got about a pound of hamburger here, maybe a little bit over. Throw it in. I just throw it all in. I mean, I don't claim to be a cook. And then this is the fun part. You just kind of mix it all up. I was supposed to actually give it a shot of ketchup. So I'm going to have my lovely assistant here who's holding the camera.
Juggle the camera and the ketchup.
Yeah, juggle the camera and the ketchup. We can do ketchup and camera and whatever. I mean, for you ketchup lovers, man, this is awesome, because it's pretty much what gives it, like, its flavor, besides, you know, if you want to throw in some onions.
I'll tell you right now, though, it doesn't look too appetizing.
What do you mean?
It tastes good afterwards.
No, it looks like freaking roadkill.
Yeah.
But it tastes pretty good, you know, if you bake it on...
How's it feel on your fingers?
Interesting.
Squishy?
Very squishy. And basically, you just want to mix up the egg, the breadcrumb, and all that stuff. I try not to like mash it too much. I try to just more mix it more than anything. And then we're gonna
I keep blocking the light.
You know what, actually? If I can maybe I can pop open that. Can you get that ketchup and hold that camera?
I'll give it a stab.
You can do it. I know you can do it.
You can just wash the ketchup off after, no big deal.
Are you sure?
Oh, okay, never mind.
I'll do it. I don't care.
Whatever. Show me what you want. You got holes?
Yeah, no, I'll do it. I got it.
You sure? No, yeah, I got... No.
Yeah. Yeah, we just have some... squirt a little bit of ketchup in there. This is all pretty much to your own discretion. I usually go by, you know, how it looks.
Oh, it's fun making meatloaf, huh?
How it smells. If you put too much ketchup, it'll taste like ketchup.
But, some people like to put ketchup on the top, too.
Some people don't like this, you know, but I mean, this is simple for me, you know, it's just a, and then, you know, I basically, you just kind of whip it in the oven on 350 for about, I don't know, 35 minutes, 45 minutes, whatever it takes until it's cooked all the way through. I put it in a Pyrex glass bowl, and, you know, you can get real fancy with it. You can go ahead and put tomato sauce on it. I've heard of people doing that, various tomato sauces. But the main thing is that, you know, the egg, the hamburger, and the breadcrumbs. And I really think that moistening the breadcrumbs works pretty good. I've even used oatmeal when I didn't have breadcrumbs. Dry oatmeal, like quick 1-minute oats, and that works pretty good. And, you know, you can put onions, you can put peppers, you can put garlic.
Sometimes you can put a little breadcrumbs and a little bit of...
Oh, yeah, and if you want to make I'm just having fun right now. And if you want to make a gravy, well, you know, there's you can basically buy any kind of base and then get creative as all hell with that and make your own gravy. But this usually works pretty good for me because when it comes out and it's cooked, I usually just throw it on my plate and add some more ketchup on top of it, salt the shit out of it, couple baked potatoes and some...
Quick question, when you make your meatballs, do you make it just without the ketchup and just basically the same thing, but make
balls? Yeah, meatballs, you don't use ketchup, no. The meatballs, you do your spices. Basically, it's the same kind of mix, but you don't want to mess with them too much. You kind of, because if you mess with them and like clump them all together, they have a tendency to cook tough. I found that, anyway. But, yeah, the meatballs, that's a whole different thing. You use all your seasonings and your spices in the actual breadcrumbs and the meat, the hamburger. And I think that I actually use an 85% fat hamburger when I make stuff like this because a little bit of fat actually is pretty good for getting like a more tender product. So, but anyway, I just figured I'd share this with people because everybody's looking for recipes, and it's quick, it's fast. I mean, I'm done. I made this in like 5 minutes. I'll throw it in the oven. I'll cook it. It'll get all nice and...
You're moving out of the shot again.
oozy and oily and whatnot, and then you eat it, and it's good. You know, you throw some... I got some steamed vegetables and a couple baked potatoes, and it's a pretty good meal. So anyways, check it out if you like it.
We'll post pictures when we're done cooking it.